Good evening and welcome to The Spark.
We're your host. I'm Brianna Whistle.
And I'm Megan Briner. But wait, shouldn't this be a little bit more formal?
Oh, no. Not here on The Spark.
So what exactly is The Spark?
Great and totally not scripted question, Megan. The Spark is a brand new show where we'll be featuring segments that you don't normally see on The Daily Show. Every quarter, we'll be releasing two episodes with not only new hosts, but new segments.
So no more good morning, I'm...
Not here.
Okay, so what's coming up on today's show?
Well, for our first ever show, we'll be kicking it off, no pun intended, with a penalty shoot-off featuring our boys and girls soccer teams.
A series of Busch Gardens vlogs by our junior class.
A quick commercial break.
A special Valentine's Day segment.
And finally, a segment we call Chicken Shop, where we'll be featuring your favorite teacher, Mr. Monty.
So without further ado, let's
light the spark. You know, from what I've been hearing, it's been pretty difficult for our boys and girls varsity soccer teams.
Yes, it's really the make or break moment for them.
But have we ever seen them go against each other?
I don't think so.
Well, luckily for us and the viewers, last week we gave them the opportunity to face off.
Here's our varsity girls and boys soccer team going head to head in a penalty shootoff.
Hi guys, welcome back to FBTV. My name's George Gonzalez.
I'm Olivia Vargas, and today we're going to be taking PKs, the girls versus the guys. I think the girls are a lot better at PKs, but...
We're going to let the pens decide.
Daniela Todd, and I'm going top left.
Good job.
I didn't save it. I went the right side. I went the correct way. I didn't save it. I'm so mad at myself. I hate what that happens.
My name is Martin Ranga, and I'm going to go top right.
Yo no escuché nada. Yo no escuché nada.
Será comió?
Oh, hell no.
I knew he was going left. So I don't know why the damn thing went right. What?
Hi, I'm Gayo, and I'm going bottom right.
Bottom right is crazy.
No left.
Hi, my name is TC. I'm chipping the goal. Yeah.
I know where TC is going. He's going to my left. I know where he's going. Wow, I can't save nothing now? Save two other start. No, I don't save anything, bro.
Kiki? Bottom right.
Okay, my name's JJ, and I'm gonna go bottom left. There's some ops here, so I can't. Like, I'm covering my mouth because there's ops.
JJ's trying to go to my left. I reset this, but I'm going to my left. You ready, JJ?
JJ, let's go down this. Oh my god.
What do you make?
See!
I trusted you!
Well, I'm happy the guys won. It's a great confidence booster.
No.
The evidence is there. Hopefully we get to states. Hopefully we do good in the next few games and playoffs. Hopefully we don't, you know, lose in pens again. Okay, yeah, so bye. Thank you. Thank you for everybody, and yeah.
See! You know, I'm really glad we got to film something like that. I've always wanted to see those two go head to head. I knew it would always be some kind of chaotic commotion.
Speaking of chaotic commotion, do you remember what happened on February 4th?
The junior trip.
There's been a lot of mixed reviews about it, from those who loved the drops and loops to those who thought the lines were endless.
Well, Here's a series of vlogs brought to you by the junior class and their trip to Busch Gardens.
Good morning, Fibers. Welcome to the class of 2024.
Good morning. Hello, everybody. Hi. Hey, say hello. Oh, what's up? What's up? We're on the bus. It's 5:21, and mommy just texted.
Hi, guys. We're on bus 5. It's your class treasurer and staff secretary. We have an hour and 30 minutes left. For Firebird TV, we have...
A few moments later.
Hi everyone! We made it! We're in the park.
We're going to Cheetah Hunt.
Okay. Cheetah Hunt and Cobra's Curse were closed.
Boo!
Guys, update. We're on our first ride. We're going on what? Montu.
Montu, that was good. We didn't wait that long and I rated 8.5.
I rated it 9. That was really good.
I loved it.
What's your favorite ride?
This one.
This one, what's this ride called?
Iron Gosling.
Water. Why do you like it?
Because it's the best one here. Tallest, steepest.
What was your favorite ride of the day?
This one, what is it?
Iron what?
Water. Bruh.
These are the questions for the vlog today. Now, bye.
So, I'm your historian.
I'm your president.
And we just went on, what was it?
Wait,
the Iron Gwazi. Yeah. Guys, rate the Iron Gwazi 1 out of 10. What is it?
Actually, 20 out of 10.
11?
10,000 out of 10. 10,000 out of 10.
1 out of 10 for the Iron Gwazi. Come on. 1,000,000 out of 10!
No,
it's
not the case because I
Everything is broken.
Everything is closed.
Closed down.
Everything
experiences have been fun.
Yes.
Yeah.
Everything happens for a reason.
Okay, guys, I'm back on this because what? Everybody has sunglasses except for me.
Now, from 1 to 10, rate Busch Gardens today.
Like a 9.
An 8.98.
Right. What? 8.98. That was so specific.
Honestly, it would have gotten the 9, but the Cheetah Hunt 9 was a little, crazy.
Bro, I was there for like 2 hours. Not even an hour.
Yeah,
so I was there for 2 hours.
And the power was out when we first got there, so we had to wait. And we had a whole plan.
Yeah. And the rides were closed. Our plan didn't go according to plan. But, you know, like, we improvised and it worked out.
Yeah, they were making excuses to skip in line, this and that. And they're basically Karens. They're Karens. That's
in every line. There was, like, one in every line. Yeah.
Those lines look brutal, and I'm really not a fan of roller coasters.
Me neither. But you know what I really, really, really like right now, Megan?
No.
Megan, I like how the show is coming out so far.
And we're officially halfway through.
So I think it's about time we take a quick break.
We're bringing you a commercial break brought to you by the Grizzly Bear. The Grizzly Bear.
The what?
Are you lonely this Valentine's Day, like my good friend here? Well, we have a solution for you, the Grizzly Bear. Grizzly will be your companion for only $19.99. You can go on cute dates like going on walks and watching the clouds. So this Valentine's Day, use the Grizzly Bear to cure your loneliness. Scan the QR code if you don't want to be lonely.
So that's what the Grizzly Bear was.
Yes, and it's just in time for Valentine's Day.
I think people would have appreciated seeing the stuffed animal a little before Valentine's.
Hey, give it some credit. Some people actually like it.
I guess. What did you do for Valentine's Day, Megan?
Girl, I'm so single, it's not even funny. What about you?
I celebrated on Saturday.
Aw, that's cute. I wonder what other Valentine's Day story people have.
Well, luckily for you, some of our crew went out in the middle of lunch to ask you guys some stories about the special day. Here's what they had to say.
Hey guys, I'm Kiara.
And I'm Kenza. We're here at A Lunch.
And we're gonna ask some people some questions for Valentine's Day.
Am I gonna be in the background?
Hello, can we ask you a question?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Barbie.
Okay, what have you ever been rejected or did you ever reject somebody?
Someone asked me to the 8th grade prom and he danced with another girl instead of me.
Okay.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure thing.
Okay, so what's your favorite love song and can you perform it?
My favorite love song? Girl from Ipanema. Tall and tan and young and lovely.
Okay, what's your best pickup line?
You kind of got me there, bro.
You can't think of one?
Are you Tennessee? Because you're the only 10.
The girl from Ipanema goes walking in as she passes.
Did you ever get rejected before?
No.
Who's he lying to?
Because I never asked. I didn't make the...
I've been rejected. In third grade, I gave him chocolates and he said no.
On Valentine's Day? Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, thank you.
Go to someone and ask them to be your Valentine.
Can you be my Valentine, please? Please. No.
Look, please go. All right, that's the end of lunch.
Something.
That's what you're stuck on? I'm still thinking about those pickup lines. Do you think they actually use them on people?
I hope not.
You know, some people do enjoy that cheesy stuff though.
Speaking of cheese, I'm really hungry.
Megan, that was extremely random. But so am I.
This next segment is gonna be the worst for us and our stomachs, but the best for you guys.
Mr. Monty, whether you have him or not, you know his name.
Every time I ask about him, there's always a new story to be told.
He's always making sure you're not comiendo lo que pica el pollo.
And the triangle.
Megan, the rhetorical triangle. Come on.
Okay, then.
Here's Leo with a brand new segment called Chicken Shop, where we'll be featuring Mr. Monty.
Hey, it's good to be here.
Look at pica el pollo, as you can see, the cuisine.
I'm honored. I did not think that I would be invited to that very special place. You know, it's hard getting a table at Look at pica el pollo.
Pretty hard. Reservations were a few years back.
Oh, absolutely. I'm laughing at it because people thought that no one would go to and choose Look at pica el pollo over any other chicken place, but they're unique here. They're truly unique.
Chicken. Especially
chicken and the type of chicken they have, and they also sell eggs. How do you feel about being here?
Well, like we said, the reservations were a bit hard to get, but... Mm-hmm.
Did you have an insider connection?
I did have to speak to some people to get me in, but it's...
Are they regulars? You find them here often, right?
Unfortunately, I told them to quit it, but...
Are they former students or current students in my AP Lit or Lang courses? Some of them even in grade books.
Your current students, yes.
Okay. Believe it or not, I had chicken. I had chicken for breakfast today.
Today.
I had chicken for lunch. Last night, I had... Yesterday, pardon me. I had chicken for lunch and chicken for dinner. It sounds funny, but yeah, I'm kind of on an 80% chicken diet. For better or for worse, I'm hoping to lose a few pounds.
From eating chicken?
From eating chicken. Only. No. Only chicken.
Go ahead.
We're ready? Okay, let's do it. Let me pick this out.
Yeah.
Here you go. I think it was I was inspired by three teachers in high school. Those people inspired me because they made me see that through literature, a lot of the world could be revealed. I said, you know what? I think I'd like to do this. In the back of my mind, I want to teach. If not history, then literature. So that's ultimately what led me here into the profession about 25 years ago.
You talked about your profession as a teacher,
mm-hmm.
but have you ever thought about becoming an actor?
Well, I don't want to give this away. Okay.
It's a secret.
I'm going to say it. I have been, and I think I deserve some. Recognition and credit for this. I'm not really a teacher. I'm acting as a teacher, and it gives the impression I'm doing it so well that it gives the impression that I'm really a teacher. But I'm really acting as a teacher. That's my role. I've been doing the same role for years. I'm an old English teacher. And the fact that you asked me, have I thought about acting, clearly proves the fact that you didn't know that I was acting. So yes, I've been acting all along. I'm worried that this might put me to sleep. Aren't you concerned about that?
This chicken?
Yeah. What do you think?
I'm feeling a bit drowsy. I haven't had that many bites, but it's definitely having some impact.
I told you, that's why we're going to have dessert.
Do you accept credit card here?
You know, I never asked. And if they're strictly cash, you know what that means. What kind of business they're in. Any business that's strictly cash, whoops, you know what that means.
Do teachers sleep in school? Do they stay here?
I think some teachers hibernate.
Stay in class.
Yeah, I think there are teachers that probably go into a dark cabinet, a wardrobe, and they probably hide it in there. That's where they are, like bears. Do they stay in school? Well, maybe some of them do. Maybe there's one hiding in there. I don't know.
I brought this, and this is gonna be a more
dessert
series. No, not dessert. Not dessert just yet.
Oh, okay.
It's gonna be a bit shocking. The restaurant has asked me,
is this a dossier on me that they've kept?
No, well, sort of. I'm gonna show you some pictures, and they just want you to see what comes to mind.
Like a Rorschach test?
Look, at Pica el Pollo just wants to know how you think, because obviously you've gone against them for many years. They have grown to not like you that much, because you know the reputation, you go against the reputation.
Well, so because I speak my truth.
Now that we're here, I'm gonna show you some pictures, you
okay.
Tell me
all right.
What comes to mind.
I'll tell you, I'm not comfortable with it. This feels like, almost like dinner with Morty here.
first things first. Does this make you think of anything specific?
This makes me feel, makes me think of the most sacred number, the Trinity, the number three, and of course, the literary pyramid.
Of course.
Also, the last UFO I've seen.
It was?
Triangle. With about 12 lights on the side. Yes.
You saw it?
I saw one.
Where?
Going up that extension that goes in back of Perimeter Road through the airport. This looks like a little box of little mints that you put in your mouth for bad breath.
Maybe it's something to wash yourself with.
Handy wipes?
No.
Is it
when
the type
shower.
Of... Oh my... Oh, wow.
I need to put it closer.
Cherry soap.
Yes.
Yeah.
Does
yes.
That soap
yeah, doesn't me? Ring a bell.
No.
It doesn't ring a bell.
Last picture. Can you explain what's going on in this picture?
I'm very ashamed of that. That's when I got very, very angry at Buster.
Buster?
Yeah. And I got up on one of the desks and I was yelling and screaming at Buster.
What did he do, dude?
Someone helped him speak. And so I got very angry. Look at me, look at that.
Yeah,
I can see normally am not like that. I don't get that way. I don't.
Okay.
I have a little bit of here, but you know, he doesn't want to take food from me.
Yeah.
What'd you do that for?
No, sorry, just...
That's what I do. That's what I do.
So, Mr. Monty,
I think you just ruined the moment.
This moment?
Yeah, you did that.
I'm sorry.
You're not supposed to do that. Okay.
Let me just explain.
Okay. All right.
No,
all
let
right.
me explain myself. Let
okay.
me just.
All right.
He just told me the idea. He gave me the idea, Buster.
Of what?
Doing that. I know.
That's why we have problems. That's why we have that picture.
I didn't want to invite him. Let me tell you. Okay. I'm sorry. He was the insider in Lo Que Pica El Pollo that invited us here.
So he's the guy.
Yeah.
That's. The mole that's been in our class.
I'm sorry. Yes.
That's the guy. I was trying to figure out what's going on here. And so many people going to Lo Que Pica for you. All these coupons all over the place.
Now I understand why you got mad at him in that picture. I get it.
He's now on probation.
And even that poster up there is...
That breaks my heart. Because that's our battle flag.
Yeah.
That's a battle flag of rhetorical. I don't know what to think. I'm just beside myself. Despite what has happened, thank you for inviting me to Lo Que Pica El Pollo, and please do tell the proprietor of Lo Que Pica El Pollo that the chicken's gotten better.
Gotten better, at least.
Yeah, the chicken's gotten better, but, you know, I still see it. Look around here. What do you see? See the chickens?
Yep.
Look at this one.
Yeah.
Look at this real light in red right here.
You're still pink, right?
Well, yeah, you got the coupons.
Yeah.
I'll pay for the dessert. Thanks a lot.
Thank
it's
you.
Good to see you. Oh, before we go.
Yes.
One more. Okay. Cheers.
To you.
Wow, that really made me hungry.
Me too, so let's try to, you know, wrap this up.
This is officially the end of our first ever episode of The Spark.
We want to thank you all so much for tuning in and making it all the way to the end.
This was truly an experience, not only for us, but for everyone who participated.
We hope you guys have an amazing rest of your weekend.
Reporting for...
No, don't do that.
Well, what else am I supposed to say? Exactly. Reporting for The Spark, I'm Megan Brenner.
And I'm Brianna Hueso. Make sure to keep an eye out for episode 2.